The most important thing you must do when you're trading shares is to apply a stop limit order. As soon as you bought them, apply this. This protects you from losing too much money and it protects your capital. Therefore, you can carry on trading. So if the shares do go down, you don't have to be watching them to sell them. So you can get out quick and use your capital to reinvest. I'm going to give an example here. Taylor Wimpey, I bought 35 shares in Taylor Wimpey yesterday. And I paid $142.55. I'm now going to apply the stop limit order. Admittedly, that is a day late, but here we go. Taylor Wimpey shares, 35 shares. And to determine what your stop limit order is going to be, I like to look at the ratios of what the value has been over the last 52 weeks, and the price has ranged from a pound and a penny to 238. So I'm going to put the stop price on. So what I do now is go back to the shares and I go to sell and I go to stop limit, and it's the full number of shares I'm going to sell. And the stop price, this is the price below the current price that converts your order to a limit order. So I'm going to put in a pound and a penny, 101. So if a price drops from 145 down to 101, I immediately get out of the market. And then the next thing is put the limit price. This is the minimum price you are willing to get per share. So the shares are put on the market at a pound and a penny, but if there's a dropping market, the price may drop further. So to protect myself even further, I'm going to put in a limit price, and I'm going to put that in at 95 pence. So worst case scenario, I would sell my shares for 95 pence each. But the shares could go a bit wrong any time of the day. You don't have to be sitting watching the screen all day to get that level of protection. And this should be done to every share you own in your portfolio, so you know that you are protected. And one more thing, expiration end of day. Now I want this set until good to cancel. So this order will be in place until I decide to cancel it or if the shares reach that price. So reviewing the order, and there we go. It's a stop limit sell. Number of shares 35. The value is 33.25. The stop price, the price has got to reach or drop down to 101 pence. Then that will set the wheels in motion. And the absolute least I'll get for them is 95 pence. So I'm going to send a sell order. So that's been put in place to protect those shares. I'm going to go through all my other shares and do the same. So that's one thing you must do after you purchase your shares. Protect your capital. And if the shares do drop, you're not going to lose the whole lot. So this is one of the most valuable pieces of information that I can ever tell you. So until next time, I bid you a very, very goodbye.